In today's video, I'll show you a doctor that's already treating people suffering from kidney disease with an innovative stem cell treatment. This is not simply a breakthrough in the field of regenerative medicine. This could change the lives of many people with kidney disease. My name is Catherine and this is 00 Kidney. If you're new here, welcome to our journey together to a better kidney health. In the last few years, researchers and doctors have made impressive steps forward in treating very complicated diseases using stem cells and regenerative medicine. Diseases that were incurable, such as leukemia, heart disease, osteoarthritis, spinal cord injuries, Parkinson's disease, type 1 diabetes, and even cancer, are now being successfully treated with stem cell therapies. And this is not news. What you may not know is that there are clinics in the world already treating and curing, at least at some degree, kidney disease with stem cell therapy. Yes, this is happening right now. So, are doctors already curing kidney disease with stem cell therapy? Well, let's take a look at what this clinic is offering. It's a clinic specialized on stem cell therapy and regenerative medicine. They promise to cure kidney disease even in people in stage 5 using an innovative treatment. They also have tons of happy customers showing their appreciation on their website. Now, I have already talked about the incredible promises of stem cell, so I'm not entirely surprised to know that this clinic is already using them to treat kidney disease. Now, the very interesting part is that they're actually offering a treatment based on cord tissue-derived mesenchymal stem cells. This is interesting because, according to the Harvard Stem Cell Institute, these mesenchymal cells that are found in the bone marrow, or like in this case in the umbilical cord, can play a significant role in kidney healing. These stem cells can be transplanted into the body to promote the regeneration of damaged kidney tissue and reduce overall inflammation. And while the debate for ethics of stem cells is not over yet, these stem cells are not embryonic stem cells. Sourcing them doesn't require the disruption of an embryo. We are talking about pluripotent stem cells here. Stem cells sourced from the umbilical cord. The clinic's spokesperson also claims they're sourcing them from the American Association of Tissue Bank, which is an association of certified suppliers of full-term, ethically US-donated human umbilical cords. Now, this is the kind of stem cells that are being studied and tested today in many clinical trials, especially by the Harvard Stem Cell Institute. And while researchers from Harvard are testing these stem cells in their clinical trials, this clinic is way beyond testing. They are already offering this as a treatment for kidney disease. What the doctors in this clinic are doing is deploying the stem cells systemically via IV to the patient. It's a very simple protocol actually. It's a 4-day trip to their clinic in the Cayman Islands. After arriving there, the first day you get the physical assessments and supporting therapies the second day. Then you get injected with 300 million cord tissue-derived mesenchymal stem cells the third day. Now, this number, 300 million of cells, shouldn't go unnoticed because it's a lot more than what many clinical trials are using. Then the fourth day, you get a checkup and then you can leave. There is also a detox regimen involved, a vitamin therapy and some supplements. Note that this kind of therapy is very popular amongst celebrity and athletes. The Cayman Islands Clinic has the endorsement from celebrities such as Lou Ferrigno, the Hulk of the movies from the 70s, and other actors and sportsmen. But what kind of result could someone suffering from kidney disease expect from this new kind of stem cell treatment? Well, according to the medical director of the clinic, a reasonable outcome of a stem cell therapy will be the marked reduction in inflammatory markers when compared to pre-treatment levels and a marginal increase in kidney function. This would likely not be sufficient to remove a patient from dialysis after one therapy, but the hope will be to reduce dialysis frequency. Okay, if this is true, it's probably the biggest breakthrough in the treatment of end-stage renal disease I have seen in my entire life. I mean, we all know how hard it is to get kidney function back when a patient reaches stage 5 of kidney disease. Now, this doctor, this medical director, says that with just one shot of 300 million mesenchymal stem cells, you can get better immediately. Now, what you may ask is, but does this really work? Are they really curing kidney disease with stem cells already in 2020? Well, there are reasons that led me to believe that an improvement for people with kidney disease could be possible with this kind of treatment. I'm saying this because of what the Harvard Stem Cell Institute found in their recent trials. According to them, there's a specific type of mesenchymal cells that plays a significant role in kidney healing. These stem cells can be transplanted into the body to promote the regeneration of damaged kidney tissue and reduce overall inflammation. But please don't get your hopes too high yet. There are also reasons why I don't recommend you to consider this specific treatment as a viable way to treat kidney disease. First of all, there are currently no FDA-approved treatments for kidney disease that use stem cells. There are also no treatments approved in Europe either. Actually, the clinic I'm talking about is situated in Grand Cayman, in the Caribbean. And I'm not saying that I don't trust what the medical director of this clinic says or the celebrities that endorse him. What I'm saying is that right now, trying to cure kidney disease with just an injection of stem cells is a shot in the dark. Also, it's not covered by any insurance since it's not approved by the FDA. So the treatment is going to cost you $20,000. Also note that they have only one price and one protocol for any treatment you want. You have kidney disease, it's $20,000 for one injection. You have Alzheimer's, it's $20,000 for one injection. You have an autoimmune disease, it's still $20,000 for one injection. But also for chronic inflammation, Crohn's disease, diabetes, and so on. They say they can cure a lot of health problems and conditions. Same treatment, same price. Doesn't really sound believable to me that all these pathologies will receive all these benefits from the same identical treatment. Also, there's a very important reason why these new treatments are still not approved by the FDA and are not available to the public. Scientists have yet to isolate the specific cells responsible for kidney repair. This is why only general systematic stem cell therapy is available to fight kidney problems. So they're basically injecting you with 300 million mesenchymal stem cells. And then what happens? What are these cells going to do? To understand this, we need to know a little bit more about stem cells. Well, stem cells are important to us because of their ability to divide repeatedly, growing into a large number of cells, which, for some kinds of stem cells, can form complex structures. Stem cells are involved in the development of all the structures in the human body. The essential idea is that if some part of the body is missing or flawed, then we can, roughly speaking, grow a new one using stem cells. This is what stem cells do. They develop into any cell type to replace the cells in a damaged organ. But putting this idea into practice can be very difficult. The development and maintenance of the various structures of the human body takes place in a very specialized environment with all kinds of signals going around and pushing cells into various forms. And even then, it often doesn't work. For example, early miscarriages of malformed embryos are actually pretty common. This is why the FDA doesn't approve the practice of just injecting some stem cells into someone and expect those cells to turn into exactly what that person needs. So the problem is getting your stem cells to turn into the cell type you want to replace, alright? And not into something else, because this requires knowing and replicating the conditions which these cells experience during normal development, which is not as easy as it may sound. This problem is particularly troublesome when we deal with stem cells that can develop into any kind of cells, in particular, pluripotent stem cells. These are the cells the Cayman Clinic is going to use, since these cells can grow into pretty much anything. But since, again, they can grow into pretty much anything, they can also grow into something we don't want, like cancer. Yes, the main risk here is that these 300 million mesenchymal stem cells are not going to turn into kidney cells, but into something else. Now, I'm not going to tell you that they give you cancer in this clinic in the Cayman Islands, but I'm also not telling you to buy a plane ticket to fly there. So, my advice here is to keep monitoring the progress of stem cell therapies and, most important, the clinical trials going on. Clinical trials may be an interesting way for someone with kidney disease to receive a stem cell treatment without the risk of going to an offshore clinic and being administered a treatment not approved by the FDA. Now, every time I talk about these breakthrough treatments in my videos, I keep getting the same questions in comment section. How can I get this treatment? Regarding this stem cell treatment, there are two ways to get it. The first will be to fly to this clinic in the Cayman Islands and to pay $20,000. The second will be being part of a clinical trial. There are clinical trials going on all around the world testing the most recent therapies involving stem cells. And there are actually several studies that are going to test these therapies on people suffering from chronic kidney disease. Now, if we take a look at the website clinicaltrials.gov, which is the most up-to-date database about the clinical trials actually going on and recruiting test subjects, we may see that there is need for people with kidney disease willing to test these treatments. Let's take a look at this website because it's very interesting. These are the clinical trials actually authorized by the US and European government agencies. Here, you can sort clinical trials by disease, by country, and by city. You can also see which studies are actually recruiting patients and for what purpose, and get info on what kind of requirements they are going to need. Now, unlike the therapy proposed by the Cayman Island Clinic, being part of one of these trials will be totally free of charge for the patient. And while not all these treatments are going to help you or are even aimed at finding something capable of helping people with kidney disease, if there is something that works and that will be the cure for this disease, it is going to come out from one of these clinical trials. This is why I think many of you watching me right now may be interested in knowing more about these studies. Now, if you are thinking about participating in a clinical trial, consider that usually first contact with the team of researchers will be made by your doctor. So be sure to get them involved if you think you can meet the criteria and the treatment will be helpful for you. But in the database, you can also find the email addresses of the researchers responsible recruiting volunteers, usually, and you may be able to contact them if you think you meet the requirements. This is all for today, but stay tuned because there is a new video coming next Tuesday. And as usual, feel free to ask any question in comment section or in the Double O Kidney Facebook group. I usually try to answer all the questions that I can. For now, I want to say thank you for watching me today, and as always, I want you to prioritize yourself, take care of you, and do all your best to live your healthiest life. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you soon. Goodbye.